sorry about that, because this edition of the Adult Demographic is sponsored by King Cobra. Then we get a little Buzz Aldrin promo backstage, and then Mark Henry just hits him with a chair. It was funny. It really was. Third match of the night. This is a short match. This is Zach Morris versus Evan Justborn. Just 2 minutes. Has Alicia Kim. I'm sorry, Alicia Kim. Alicia Fox and Gail Kim out there. Now, last week it was all about their... Well, Alicia's a heel. Gail Kim's a face. They're sitting together. There's no desertion. This week it all comes to a fall. You know, it looks like Zach Morris is going to go with Alicia Fox. And Evan Justborn has got Gail Kim on his side. I like it. It was a short match, a little interference at the end. We got the rolling senton into the corner or a drop kick. And then a little distraction by Alicia Fox. This is where the desertion comes in, because Gail Kim stops her. And then we get an airborne and the match is over. Now before the match, Zach Morris is saying, "Ooh, Alicia, I like the way you look." Didn't say nothing to Gail Kim. So again, they actually made a little storyline out of this, so it made some sense. And then they go into John Cena's promo. This was decent. It was a more serious, straightforward Cena. Since he's been called a lot of things in the past, which he's deserved. Okay, we'll just leave that alone. And then he says he's going to forfeit his match rematch clause if, you know, he loses. Which, of course, he's going to, because he's going to win. Come on, Batista's leaving because it's an I Quit match in 2 weeks. He owes it all to Sheamus. Sheamus comes out, does a decent job. Accepts Cena's challenge to come in the ring, and then Dave Berg comes in, a classic beatdown. I do like that how Sheamus and Dave Berg, the whole time they were like staring at each other, doing the whole beatdown, didn't turn their back. Very well played by the heels. I like how that worked. Then we had a short little Vicky and Edge segment backstage. Edge found himself a partner, wants Vicky to come down ringside, and Edge guarantees that nothing will happen to her. And the crowd starts laughing their ass off. And then we go to the fourth match of the night, which is Miz versus Tyson Kidd with Natalya. Now, the whole story of this match, again, it was only 41 seconds, was that the Miz loses, he gets to pick which member of the Hart Dynasty gets to have the U.S. title shot next week in Montreal. Guess what? Old school roll-up by Owen Hart, by D.H. Smith did the old Owen Hart schoolboy roll-up. And match is over. He challenges Bret Hart next week in Montreal. Again, you say screwjob. He's leaving the company after this month anyways. After this next week anyways. He's going to cut his ties. I wish you best of luck, Bret Hart. We love you, man. You had a good little run back in the WWE. Then we had a little Dave Berg interview with Josh Matthews. It sucked, but at least it was short. And then we had a match, which is the Froshoff, which is the NXT rookies, versus the Varsity Club of Morrison, Tatsu, Goldust, and Santino. This match is only 3.5 minutes long. But guess what? My boy Brian Danielson gets the win. That's right, Danielson gets the win on a stupid little roll-up on Santino. Who cares? He was only in the match for 5 seconds. He gets the win. And now we go backstage to a Flavor Flav, Bella's Kozlov Santino skit, which they're talking about the nighttales.com. And this is pretty funny. Kozlov says he needs a restraining order to get away from Santino. And then we get a Regal rap session, which is pretty fucking hilarious. This was good stuff. Kozlov wanted him to bust a move, and he did. Straight up gangster rap with the whole finger. It was fucking priceless. Now we get Batista here, sixth match of the night, which never began. This is Dave Berg versus the fire truck. That's right, Mark Henry. He just sits down in the ring, you know, just looks in the daze, just sitting there with a spotlight. Then Mark Henry comes down, looks perplexed as well. This was actually good acting by both guys. Now, this is a nice heel move. He attacked him right when he went inside the ring. That was nice. You know, Remy's climbing in the ring ropes, gets the steel chair, starts beating him in the arms with it, does a Border City stretch on him. That's right, and the match never ended because he tapped out. Now we go into the main event. This match is only 4.5 minutes long. This was Stone Cold Randy Orton. That's right, Stone Cold Randy Orton versus Edge and Debussy with Vicky at ringside. Now we've had less than 10 fucking minutes of wrestling before the main event. Complete bullshit. This is horrible. But it was your typical standard 2-on-1 match. Then R-Truth comes down, DiBiase, Debussy gets distracted, RKO, 1-2-3, show is over. But not so fast. Vicky's still at ringside, Edge is laid out, Randy Orton's gonna get her, and all of a sudden, bad acting, really bad by Vicky, she resigns. This is a fucking, I don't know, this episode of Raw was okay at best, but they're really gearing up for next week's show. I mean, 3-hour show next week in Montreal, Bret Hart send-off show. This should be a really good show. Other than that, I tap as well. I resign from this edition, the Adult Demographic. This Raw is, like I said, 15 minutes of wrestling and 7 fucking matches. I just can't believe it. Catch you guys for Impact. Also catch you for our prediction show with D-Hoss 101. Peace. We'll be right back.